Hello, I'm Christina from Milan Creative Co. In a previous tutorial, I showed you how to make printable planners in Illustrator, and today I want to show you how to create simple mockups for your printables in Photoshop. I'm sure you know that you need attractive images to promote your freebies or products on social media, so we are going to make a simple image template for Pinterest. Open Photoshop and create a new document. I'm using a canvas that's 800 pixels by 1200 pixels. The resolution is set to 72 pixels per inch and the color mode to RGB. The background content is set to white. Click Create to continue. Double-click on the background layer to unlock it. My printables have white background, so I'm going to use this very light pink to recolor the background. You can also use a photo or a texture as background for your printables. Now I'm going to switch to Illustrator, and I have here two printables that are in Illustrator file format. You can also open PDFs using Illustrator. So I'm going to save the first printable as a JPEG file. So just use the Save for Web option to export the file. I'm going to do the same with the second printable. Now let's go back to Photoshop and import the files. So just go to File, Place, search for your file and then click on Place. I am going to scale it. I want to make it 50% smaller, and then I'm going to press on the Commit Transform button. You can also just press Enter. Go back to File, Place again, and bring the second file into Photoshop. Next, I'm going to use the Move tool to rearrange the items. Make sure Auto Select is checked, then click on the item you want to move and drag it down on the canvas. Do the same for the other item. I'm going to rotate them, so click on the item you want to rotate and then go to Edit, Transform, Rotate. Press Enter to save. Then click on the other item and go to Edit Transform, or press Ctrl T or Command T. And that will bring up the bounding box and you can rotate the item. The last step is to add shadows to our mockups. So go to the Layers panel, double click next to the name of the layer you want to edit, and the Layer Style panel will open. Choose Drop Shadow for the menu, it's the last option, and use the following settings. I use the Blend Mode Multiply. I use a dark gray color, it's set to 949494. I'm going to increase the opacity a bit to 30%, I think this is better. I usually like to use an angle of 0 degrees, make sure you use Global Light is checked. I'm going to make the distance just a little bit smaller, like 5 pixels, and the spread I'm also going to make it 5%, and I'm going to leave the size as 10 pixels. You can play with the settings until the shadows look the way you want them to, and then press OK to save. Let's add the shadow to the second image. I'm going to go back to the Layers panel, right-click on the first layer, select Copy Layer Style, and then I'm going to go to the second layer and paste Layer Style. As you can see, the second layer also has a shadow now. Next, I'm going to use the Type tool to add the name of the image. If you want to change the order of the images, you can do so by bringing the first layer above the second layer in the Layers panel. I think this looks much better. Use the Save for Web option to create images for your blog or for social media, and also make sure to save a copy as a Photoshop file. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to see more Photoshop and Illustrator tutorials, please subscribe to my channel or visit my blog. Thanks for watching!